CS so far is JJS pseudo. Looks like he wanted to maybe harass JJS a little bit, but with 360 move speed as well as an Orb of Venom. Oh, look at that bash on a pseudo now, and maybe he could get the 17%. Not going to go for the charge. I think it was worth it to charge that. But he is a little bit scared, it seems. Really, these supports are so far away right now. They are going to get the pull through, and I think if you charge him there, you maybe get the kill. Yeah, he's got the ultimate as well, and pseudo's got to be careful. JJS, I think you just go for this. Trade your life if you have to, but I don't even think they've got the damage to kill him. Will buy a TP. He's got to be a little bit careful. There it is. JJS, just turn around and ult pseudo. He does have his ultimate now, though, and it looks like he will just charge away. He's going to go right through that stack. Looks like actually getting the double bash here. Not sure how he bashed that creep. This Windrunner is going to grab a stack here, so it looks like not only was she really doing well in that lane, but she did get some stacks here. I'm not sure if it was her, the Witch Doctor, who was stacking for her, but now it looks like they will find the stack, but it's way too late. Although Kleep could find himself caught out. He is going to try and juke it for a little bit. Does have a 7-1 charge, isn't going to use it just yet, and he will be able to get out of this gank. He's going to really stretch it to the edge here with that magic wand. Could have maybe looked to turn it around with it, but instead just going to back up and go home and pulverize it with no ult for 60 seconds. Not going to be able to secure a kill for another while as Clockwork. There it is. Actually getting the flare kill? Oh my lord. That was fantastic. That was huge. Now Mr. J, 2-0, the only kills on the board, managing to finish up a Treads by 8 minutes in the offlane. Treads wand, and there's the hook in. Even going to be able to catch out Albardo with the battery assault. No points into the grave either. He's going to go down easily, and that's a killing spree for this Clockwork. And he's going to be a huge hassle now. They will finish up the 8-minute Midas on the Wraith King. Doesn't even matter. This Clockwork's going to have huge kill potential all around the map now. Going to be really scary up against the Windrunner as well as the Spirit Breaker, who won't be able to ult him. I think so. He does have the 3 points and a battery assault now. Yeah. So I don't think he'll be able to ult him even. And he's got a salve on this Clockwork, but does he even need it now? 1200 gold. I would just, you know what? Now go for the blade mail. I was going to say go greedy, go for the Aghanim Scepter, but screw it. Go for the blade mail here. Really give you a lot of kill potential. As Kleep is going to power shot through a couple creep camps here, and I can't believe he died to that rocket flare. Does go back to his lane, surprisingly enough, and will be going for the force staff here. So going to give him a little bit of a wider mana pool here. He is going to burn some of the mana on Sexy Steven. If he does it properly, he could look for the kill right after. As Mr. J really shining this game. He's going to rotate up. Not going to go for the rune, though. Isn't up for another 30 seconds. And really should just go for the cogs over here on the Sexy Steve. And Sexy Steve is just backing up now. I think if he hooks him, pushes him back with the cogs, he could get the kill, but not going to be able to do so. Is getting juked around a little bit. Should just look over here for the flare, as well as the hook on a Tico, and could easily get this kill, too. Just needs to throw the flare. Not going to go for it, though. Instead, looks like Puck will get a kill over on El Bardo on this Dazzle, who's not having the best game whatsoever. I think that's his third death now. And there it is. It's going to burn more mana on his Sexy Steve. But he does find himself a little bit more mana, though, so won't be able to get the kill. And I think he needs to have a Mango on him at all times, as our Drunk Wind Ranger is lagging now. No packet loss and 66 ping, so I'm doing all right. But I'm not playing either, so double damage rune will be bot lane. Could perhaps look to make a little bit of use out of that. As there it is, the flare. He's going to go out and he will see Tico. In about a millisecond, he will see Tico. And Tico does disconnect, but he's almost certainly dead anyways. So the Dazzle is going to respawn, but really, Brown Boots, an Enchanted Mango, a Tango, and a TP. 0-3, two last hits, two denies. I don't even want to look at his net worth, as it will be 893 net worth, so very far behind right now. Slammi, not doing all that bad. We'll see if he wants to get a Midas of his own here. That looks like a little bit of a weird animation bug there. And the go is going to be called. And he does see Tico, but he doesn't want to go for it. Not all that confident. Despite the fact that he's got the 4 points and a battery assault, and the Wraith King, I don't think, really has the damage to kill him whatsoever. He's going to maybe look for it now, and Pings are coming out for the Wraith King, telling Tico that he does have to be careful now. And one more cogs in this Wraith King could find himself in a whole lick of trouble. It looks like maybe they want to go on a Mr. J. Now they are going to start off with the cask. Isn't going to bounce, though. And now they've got no cask either. I'm surprised he's not just going to hook over onto Tico. And it looks like he should just hook over onto Tico right now. Please, this is the easy kill. Sexy Steve walks up. You may be able to get a kill onto him as well. Dank Maledict. And Clockwork is going to change over to Power Treads. Or excuse me, over to the Intelligence Treads. And now they're going to have the TP in here. They will spot out Tico, and he will go for him. The orb is going to hit as well as the silence. Isn't even going to spend the ultimate on a pulverizer, but not really going to be that big of a deal, and they won't be able to kill the Wraith King twice at the very least, so they will die on the Witch Doctor, but not that big of a deal. A Sexy Steve still keeping himself alive, but there it is, the Blink Dagger, 11-minute Blink Dagger over here for Pulverizer. No treads, though, and will just walk in a lane, although he doesn't have the ult for about 50 seconds, so guess that's really all he can do. It's gonna be very annoying for him. Cogs level 1, not lasting that long. Once he hits level 2, draining 120 mana, could be a bit disastrous for Sexy Steve here. As there he is, he's just gonna TP out in the creep wave, and it looks like he's actually gonna cancel it instantly, and instead now he's gonna get gone on. Gonna cogs in both heroes, and he is gonna throw out the battery assault. Is gonna bounce around a little bit to Sexy Steve. Is gonna get out though, should get out. Has 8 1 charges, he's not gonna get out. There it is, the 1 charge! Oh no, he's gonna go down. And that was a very poor TP. That's gonna be a killing spree to the Wraith King as well. And that's a kill that Wraith King sorely needed. Despite getting that early Midas, he really wasn't farming all that well. And JJS gonna get silenced up. They are gonna follow it up with the Ice Path. Not gonna land though. And JJS gonna be quite alright. The Haste from Pulverizer doesn't wanna give it up just yet. Does have the ultimate though. Not gonna be able to get him though. Ice Path in 3 seconds. And he will just charge right out to the lane. And instead, Pulverizer should look to get a kill on a core with this. Sexy Steve with no mana. Has to be a little bit careful. Pulverizer may find him, but instead just going to back off after seeing that there's no rune there. El Bardo is looking for the stack over here for the Windrunner, who is going for the straight Aghanim Scepter. So El Clasico build here, the Phase Boots Aghanim Scepter. Going for the Pump Booster first here. Going to give it a nice little bit of HP, and we'll just Power Shot out the Creep Wave. They will get rid of that ward though. They did have a Sentry Ward right where that Witch Doctor placed it, so very unfortunate for him. Top lane Pseudo buying himself a nice bit of farm. He's got 1,400 gold of his own, so could look to get a Midas as well alongside Sexy Steve's Midas and not be all that far behind, despite the fact that Sexy Steve managed to find himself a kill. But with a nice bit of CS, 72 CS against the 52 CS for Sexy Steve. Clockwork will return to the bot lane, and do we have Grave now for El Bardo? We do, but doesn't mean he can't get killed here. There's the TP into the mid lane. They do spend the ultimate. Tico's going to get caught up. JJS, Kleep's going to get hooked up. And now it looks like Mr. J wants to continue to go. Does have battery cell continuing, but looks like they will just end it there. Pulverizer's going to jump up, throw out the orb as well as the blink up onto the high ground. He's got to be careful, though. JJS is going to charge up. He needs a bash. The ultimate, no. He's going to face shift it. Now he's going to get caught inside Cogs. Look at the heal loop from El Bardo. And it looks like Mr. J will be able to secure the kill. And now El Bardo caught in the wrong place, wrong time. Ice Path going to go out, going to catch him out, as well as the 3 points in a Rocket Flare could be enough to secure the kill. Not going to be able to do so, though, as he does still have the Grave. Will throw out a Shadow Wave as well, mid lane. And this is buying Pseudo a lot of time. 1,900 gold for him. The Wraith King getting some time of his own, but 2.1k. Looks like he will be going for the Blink Dagger next. Not even going to look for finishing treads. Power Shot. Look at that, doing a lot of damage over here to Slammi. And he does have about a little over half eggs completed. We're going to have a lane ward thrown out top lane, but I don't imagine it'll last that long as they are rotating up on the puck. They will look for the kill on a Tico, and he's going to be very, very mad about that one. There it is. They are going to throw out the Dream Call as well as he's going to snap it anyways, and they will get the kill on the Witch Doctor. Just buying Pseudo even more space. ALT even going to be thrown up top lane, but not necessary whatsoever. It's actually not going to land on JJS, surprisingly enough. Goes for the die. Isn't going to get it. Pseudo not going to turn around. There it is. The silence. Do we have it? Not for another 3 seconds. JJS has to be careful. There's the silence. Leap not going to catch it. Now JJS turning around a little bit. Isn't going to eat enough damage from Pseudo, though. And it looks like he's going to continue the chase. There's the charge up onto the puck. And it looks like he will face shifted. Pseudo going to get caught behind tower. Has Leap in about 1 second. Is going to use it. Magic wand charges as well. Sexy Steve with a blink of his own, though. And it looks like now they could catch him. The power shot going to be enough to get the kill. They do manage to get the weave over here on a Polvirizer. Not going to be able to secure him, though. Do have blink in another 3 seconds, but Polvirizer, with a blink of his own, should be able to easily get out. Sexy Steve doesn't want to give it up just yet and won't do so, although Puck should be able to get out with another orb very soon. And said Sexy Steve will just rotate to the jungle, minus a creep, and back off after that as mid lane Tico. Not like this. If Mr. J sees him in lane, which he does, easy hook. Or not, is going to miss on that hook. Tico just going to turn around and back up. A-Alt even going to get thrown up mid, but not going to hit on anything. And this is reminiscent of the Cloud 9 days at MLG Columbus when they took first place. A-Alt, as well as 4 points and a flare, just doing so much damage. Chop lane now, it looks like they are going for it. And now, there it is, the blink up from Polvirizer has the Dream Coil. Not going to be able to catch it on the Sexy Steven. Now, Bardo in a little bit of trouble. Isn't going to be able to go down just yet. Does have the Grave not going to land. But there's the ultimate from Tico channeling it up. They charge through. Actually going to hit on the Jakiro as well as the Clockwork. There's the Bash as well. He's got the ultimate if he wants to spend it. Pseudo, there's the Leap to hold JJS in place for a little bit longer. As well as the Silence from Polvirizer going to land on a couple of heroes. A-Ulti even going to hit on 3. And now they can turn around. There's the Orb in. Sexy Steve getting low. He's going to pop his ultimate. Kyleep going to turn around. Not going to be able to do anything just yet. The Blink Up from the Wraith King. There's the Power Shot up. Not going to do all that much though. And it will be a 2-for-2 trade when all is said and done. 13-7. About an almost even trade, about as even as you can get, realistically. The Dire still ahead, though, in both EXP and net worth. The Wraith King very close to this puck. The Slark very close to this Windrunner. And not doing all that bad on both sides just yet. I really think this does favor the Radiant, though. The Dire does not have nearly enough late game potential. The Slark, a real mid game fighter. And there it is. Is going to use the Shadow Blade right away. He's going to walk under a Radiant Sentry Ward, though. And this is going to be an issue here. They're trying not to block the hook, but they are blocking it. And it looks like they will go on a Sexy Steve. There's the Leap up on him. And the hook to follow it up, as well as the AA ultimate. He's going to go down no matter what. So they will find the Wraith King. Does use the Midas before he dies, though, I believe. And won't be able to find his perspective, as Reborn is a little bit broken for observing and for replays. Hopefully they do fix it soon. As bot lane, JJS. Just going to CS a little bit here. Pretty content with that one. As Polvirizer going to do the same in the mid lane. Does have 2k of her own. And probably going to be looking up towards a Yule Scepter, because they've got a lot of single target stun that you can easily dodge if you've got Yule Scepter as well as Phase Shift. I mean, you can dodge the stun. You can dodge the charge. It's pretty simple to get out of a lot of the lockdown that they've gotten. Realistically, I'm not sure what a better item is. You could go Force Staff, give yourself a little bit more mobility, but the Yule Scepter not going to really, the Force Staff not going to be able to do nearly as much as the Yule Scepter will be able to do. So, and there it is. They're going to blink up on El Bardo. The A ultimate is going to hit, and he's surely going to go down to the crack damage. 80 HP, Shallow Grave not going to be able to survive long enough. Maybe he's not even going to die to the crack damage, though. El Bardo's got to be careful. It's going to throw out the Weave as well as a heal onto himself. It looks like the Orb will secure the kill. Windrunner trying to run up, but won't be able to get anything now, and Polvirizer just going to walk out, not even going to use the dodge there. Will use it now, and looks like the Shackle is going to miss here. As Clockwork, just going to throw out a flare in this bot lane. Get himself a couple CS here. Almost level 11. Once he's got that level 2 hook, going to give him a nice range increase. Going to be able to find these ganks from a little bit further away here, as we do have dust and a smoke over here from Tico. And it looks like they are going to look to maybe try to kill Pseudo. He does have another 1,000 gold. I really think he's probably going to want to go for something like the Scotty, as we do have the Midas finished up on the Ancient Apparition. 20 minutes in, or 19 minutes, I guess. 19:30, not all that late. Would have liked it more around the 15-minute mark, but they're not all that far ahead, and he hasn't really been a part of all that much. It's going to slowly start to overtake the net worth, as we see him very close to the toes of this Spirit Breaker, who's got treads, as well as an Orb of Venom, so he's not doing all that bad. 900 gold of his own as well. So they will stack the small camp. There's a TP bot. As Sexy Steve's got to be careful. Pseudo doesn't have the damage to kill him twice. Maybe with the Clockwork he does, though. A Sexy Steve, there it is. Going to start off with the right click. There it is. The hookup going to miss, though. Surprisingly enough, Sexy Steve's still alive for a little bit longer. They're trying to save the Cogs. Maybe for when he dies the second time. And there it is. He will die the second time. They are looking to get the kill. The Cogs is going to hold him in, but he will be able to blink out. They needed the Cogs to push him and to prevent that blink. They will be able to at least prevent his ultimate. for about 100 seconds, 100 and, well, way more than 100, 140, 150 seconds. So it looks like a shackle isn't going to latch. And now Kyleep is looking to go on black alongside JJS. And that one will latch. There's the focus fire as well. The Aghanim Scepter not going to have any damage reduction. Just still has a little bit. Still waiting for that level 3 ultimate. As they will spend the flare. Mr. J with the hook and another 14 seconds as well. Could look to get a kill in the Windrunner with that one. Puck getting very aggressive. Does have the Dream Coil. Manages to grab the Yule Scepter as we had expected there. And now Kyleep. And rotate behind her tower, and she should almost certainly go down once they see her. Hey, ultimate's gonna get thrown out. The Blink Dream Coil, there it is as well. The hook just to prevent any chance of a getaway there, and they will get a killing spree on this clockwork as well. So Mr. J finding a nice little bit for himself here. He's gonna start moving into the cogs next. Now that he has hit level 11, do you have the aggressive weave over here from El Bardo? Only gonna land on Black Cat over here. Polvirizer is looking in this bot lane. Sexy Steve with no ultimate just yet. He is getting pinged out now from the Witch Doctor. They are looking to chase him. Instead, though, they're going to find this stack. And this is pretty huge as well. Not going to use the Waning Rift, though. Just going to look to use the orb for it. And probably should just use the Waning Rift. There it is. Is going to use the Waning Rift. And that's a nice little net worth increase for the Dire here. They're just going to continue to extend their lead. Wraith King even having a back here is going to prevent him from farming up a little bit as well. Meanwhile, Pseudo Me getting all that he can in this top lane. Still hasn't spent his gold just yet. A little bit unsure if he wants to grab the completed Scotty. Or what he wants to do. Maybe looking towards the Silver Edge to prevent the lifesteal as well as the crit from the Wraith King. Will stop the Greater Bash as well as the move speed bonuses over here on our Spirit Breaker as well. So could be somewhat effective. Although, actually, no, Empowering Haste actually isn't active. So I don't believe it might break the Empowering Haste passive, though. I'm honestly not 100% sure. So there it is. The Blink, the Stun is going to miss, as well as the Power Shot going to be way off mark. They do have the ult on the Sexy Steve, not for 24 seconds, though. And he's going to get caught on under tower. There's a Dream Coil going to latch. He is not going to get Silenced up just yet, though. There's the Charge In. Going to dodge that one as well. Still has the Yule Scepter. It's just going to throw up the Spirit Breaker in the air. And there's the Stun out on a Slammi. He's going to go down, as well as the ult channeling from the Witch Doctor. Pseudo Me in the background. Meanwhile, I'm going to get a kill. And it looks like they are going to continue to go. And there's the Windrunner DC. She turns around, but tactical, yeah. 2-for-2 trade so far. But it's 2 supports for a core and a support. And Pseudo saying a little bit of freezing. He felt it as he's now got 2.7k. Did he find himself a killing spree there? I don't believe so. Just 2 kills. It's going to be plenty. I guess Kyleep streaming has his cam 4000 zoomed in. Oh, his hero. Oh, wait. Oh, that's odd. I thought he was talking about streaming and maybe his, like, webcam or something. So I guess he's really zoomed in. Maybe just restarting Dota. Whatever, let's do this. Alright, so he's just going to go for it. The unpause is going to come out now. JJS is going to have to be on the run. The charge out. Albardo's going to try and Shallow Grave and TP out. Should be able to do so. Will be able to get out here. And that's going to be the end of that one. As the rest of them going to get away, they will lose the Wraith King, though. Maybe Kyleep not going to be able to get out just yet. The Yule Scepter to start things off. They do have the hook from the Clockwork, I believe. Yes, they do. The Shackle is going to go out. Not going to latch on anything, though. Now Kyleep going to have to win run away. They aren't going to get the hook. It is going to hit a creep. And wasn't really many options for him to get that hook either. Pulverizer is thinking about going back in. They do have the orb as well as the Waning Rift here, and they will use it. Pulverizer just right-clicking for a little bit, trying to secure the kill with the orb. Pseudo Me's going to walk in, and look at that damage. 3.4k, and if you're unsure about what you want to grab yet, it is going to be the Scotty. There it is. So Pulverizer saying, press I. Not often I've seen that to try and be a fix. And it looks like he will just go for the DC. So we'll try to break things down as the Dire really far ahead now. Net worth, well, I mean, not that far ahead considering we're 23 minutes in. Only about a 4K difference. Isn't that big. EXP, quite big as well. But we are going to have a little bit of a break, guys. And may as well take the time to plug myself a little bit. For those of you that may be watching, PRB going to bake a cake. In Dota, in the client, My name is 5869casting, and I think they need to repause this. Yeah, they do need to repause it. But my name is 5869casting, and you can find me on YouTube, youtube.com/c/5869casting. That'll bring you directly to my channel, or you can just search up 5869casting on YouTube. That's the numbers 5869casting. Same with Twitch TV, twitch.tv/5869casting. You can find me there. I'm going to start live streaming as well as going in-game, and hopefully I can get some more viewers in there as well. I do various in-house leagues, pubcasts. I used to do some replay analysis, as well as a learning series I'm going to be releasing fairly shortly, about 10 or so episodes to help players get a little bit better. So if you're looking to get better, maybe take a look at my channel as well. And perfect timing, the game's going to restart 10 to 19, 23 minutes in, and looks like we are going to have a flare top lane. It's just going to be looking at the Ancients. There is a double stack there. Not going to look to steal it, though, as it looks like they will be going over on a Tico. He does have his ultimate in another 9 seconds. Can he live that long, though? And it looks like they are going to spend the Shallow Grave. It's going to turn around for the Maledict. Not going to hit it. It should be able to blink out over here on the... Looks like Will Yule's up next, and he's got the Blink Dagger if he wants to spend it. Gonna get canceled by the Maledict. Gonna buy himself a little bit more time yet again to phase shift. Not gonna be able to get the Dazzle kill. And it looks like now just buying himself so much time. Is he actually not gonna die? The Wraith King is gonna be able to secure the kill. And it looks like there's the charge up on a Black Cat. Now JJS has his ultimate as well, as if he wants to spend it. Ice Path's gonna be thrown down. There's the Shadow Blade up from Pseudo. Should just go into Tico. Not gonna do so just yet, though. Is gonna run back in looking for JJS. It seems I hear a hook. And it looks like it will latch. They will get the kill onto this the Witch Doctor. There's the ult from the Puck as well going down. JJS gonna snap it. Sexy Steve gonna snap it as well. Puppet's ultimate. I'm absolutely losing my mind. Can't even speak English right now. Pseudo going on to Sexy Steve. Is gonna dodge the stun with his ultimate. Not gonna be able to get anything off. And now it looks like they'll take a 4-for-1 trade. The Dire really extending their lead. And when you've got a Midas on the enemy support, you can't allow this to happen. Sure, you've got a Midas on your core, but really, this is what the Dire needs to do, and they are winning, but is it enough? Witch Doctor gonna need an ultimate in base, and this is problematic. Can't even leave yet. They will secure the mid tower. They will back after this, and it's really gonna be a lot about winning these skirmishes on the Dire. They don't really have much of an endgame goal. The Jakiro going to be good at pushing down these towers with the Liquid Fire, but Pseudo Me going to need a lot of farm alongside this Puck in order to really pressure out this map. And if Kyleep, as well as the Wraith King, can buy themselves enough time, they should be able to come back later on in the game. If this game goes to about the 40-50 minute mark, I'm really unsure if the Dire can win it unless they've got like a 6-slotted Slark and a 6-slotted Puck. And it is looking that way, as we almost have the completed Scotty now. Does bring the courier to the side shop a little bit early, but it looks like it's not for him. And we do have the almost completed Aghanim Scepter on the clockwork as well, and this is what they're going to need. They're going to need these small, or these medium, I guess, skirmishing items. And look at that. Like I said, reminiscent of Cloud9 at MLG. You hit the AALT, you hit the clockwork flare, and they've just got to return home. It's so annoying. Ice Path's going to go down. The Puck going to blink in. They're going to try and set him on the Wraith King. Not going to be able to hit it. The Orb out from Polvirizer. Not going to continue the chase. And instead, they're just going to back off with other heroes. They've got the hook from Mr. J if they want to spend it. Are just going to turn around, though. We'll use the Flare. Looking for somebody around the Ancients. Not going to find anybody, though, in Pseudo. He's just going to look to finish up his Scotty here. The rune is getting pinged out, though. Looks like he does want Pseudo to pick it up, and looks like they are going to have the charge top lane. Slammi is just going to TP out. Not going to be able to get him, and decides to go home. Is going to throw an ulti mid, I believe. Or am I wrong? I thought I saw an ulti go out. Maybe just a weird TP cancellation thing, as it looks like Pseudo is going to find out JJS, who has a charge wave if he wants to use it. And he's going to get a first hit bash anyways. And there it is, the charge out. Pseudo probably question mark? First hit bash? And he will find Polvirizer, though. Now Polvirizer in a whole lick of trouble. He's going to get stunned up. He's going to try and dodge it out. Buy him some time with the phase shift. Have the Yule Scepter and the blink out as well. There's the ult, though. He's going to dodge it with the Yule Scepter. Has the phase shift yet again. Polvirizer not going to use it, though. There it is. Finally buying him some time. Or about some nice reactions from him. Ice Path's going to go out. There's the hook over here on a cliff. Now he's going to find himself caught out. Albardo's going to throw out the Shallow Grave. He's caught up on the cliff now. Now Mr. J's going to take a lot of damage. There's the Shackle actually going to land the power shot as well. And now Puck, it looks like, barely surviving. Meanwhile, Mr. J's going to go it down, and it looks like it's going to be a 3-for-1 trade on the backside. Pseudo's going to come in with the Shadow Blade, find himself a couple kills. Sexy Steve going to pop his ultimate. We do have the Ice Path in one. Will throw it down alongside the Dual Breath, and they should be able to kill Sexy Steve. It's going to be a 4-for-1 trade. Puck barely getting out. El Bardo on the cliff, and it looks like they will at the very least find El Bardo, and it's going to be a 5-for-0. No, what is this Puck doing? Is he actually trying to survive here? Pseudo going to jump up on the cliff, and they will find El Bardo on the wrong side of the cliff, though, is Pseudo me. And look at this Puck just dancing around, and he's going to get earned up. Going to have to dodge out a lot of that damage as El Bardo, trying to buy himself a little bit of time. But Puck is going to survive, and that's going to be a godlike for Pseudo, a 5-for-1 trade. And the Dire just getting further and further. The Ancient Apparition Eggs is going to be so scary when it does finally come out, and he's a little over halfway there as well as the Scotty finished up on the Slark. Aghanim Scepter, I imagine, going to be essentially finished up on this clockwork. Once he respawns, we'll be able to tell. Puck should go for the Hex. As, still a little bit far, I guess, since Mr. J, dying for everybody's sins, will be, the first hero to kind of go down in every team fight. As ALT is going to go into the fountain. Will catch Sexy Steve, I believe. Are they going to throw out a flare as well? Looks like no. Just going to hit on Sexy Steve, and he's not going to feel all that bad about that one. It's moving in towards a BKB. Mechanism finished up on the Jakiro, who is now very tanky. Jakiro, for those of you who don't know, has one of the higher strength gains in the game. 2.30 for an int hero is pretty huge, considering his intelligence gain is only 2.80, and that's pretty massive. He's got 1,200 HP here with no items. That increases HP pool whatsoever. Meanwhile, top lane JJS, Pseudo Me is going to jump on him. There's the charge out towards the mid lane. Puck is nearby, though. Is he going to look to get the kill here? As he is just going to phase shift out a little bit. The offensive weave going out, not going to be able to catch him. And now Kyleep is going to rotate up. Doesn't have the shackle shot, though. Does have 1,800 gold. And looks like won't be able to find anything as the AL is going to be spent in case there was a chase that happened there. They won't do so. Pseudo Me, though, with the Shadow Blade. He's going to use it. That's 2.6k after finishing up that Scotty now. And he's just going to look to seal some Ancients here, it seems. And can do so considering how much HP he's got. Nice little bit of attack speed. Still has 7 stolen agility here. So going to be pretty confident going through these Ancients. And Ancients are just so tanky now with all this bonus armor that they get. Clockwork going to be able to find himself a kill on the Dazzle, who, yet again, not having the best of games here. And see what everybody's going in terms of items. It looks like, as we said, the mech over here onto Black Cat. Midas, Aghanim Scepter almost finished for Slammi. Pseudo does have the Shadow Blade as well as the Eye of Scotty. Still hasn't moved over to anything yet. Clockwork does manage to finish up his Aghanim Scepter. Puck hasn't moved in towards anything yet. JJS has the Sage, and Sexy Steve, as we said, going for that BKB. Basher now on the Slark, and that's going to be pretty annoying for them to deal with as well. They are rotating towards the bot tower. They know they need to start limiting this map control as well as the map vision. AL not going to land just yet. Tico's got to be a little bit careful. Could find himself in a very bad position. Pseudo getting very aggressive behind the enemy tower. Has to be a little bit careful. Has 4 TPs. Looks like he accidentally bought 2. Went back home, bought 2 again, and didn't realize what he had. As they are going to be able to get this tower, especially with this illusion rune giving them a little bit more DPS. Power shot is going to go out, and looks like they are committing to get this. They aren't going to go for Roshan just yet. Maybe going to look to clear out this creep wave and continue on after that. As Pseudo does get the Basher delivered. And the level 16. Actually moving up to level 18 now. Sexy Steve still with no level 16 yet. And really needs that 60 second cooldown if they really want to be able to effectively go up against these skirmishes. And there it is. The ALT. The flare is going to be thrown out as well. Not going to be doing all that much damage. His creep is fairly tanky. 1500 HP. They really need to hit some of these supports. Like El Bardo with 900 HP, or even the Witch Doctor with only 800 HP. El Bardo fairly tanky himself. They are moving over towards the Roshan. It is getting pinged out, it seems. They don't have the charge from the Spirit Breaker. They won't be able to bring him in as Mr. J is stunning up Roshan a nice little bit here. It's slowed down as well from the Liquid Fire here. And Pseudo looks like he may be the one that wants to take it. Radiant, though, they are rotating in. They've got the blink. They could find themselves a nice shackle here as well. Black Cat is going to have to throw out an ice path here to block it off, as it looks like they will shackle up on a Polvirizer. Actually going to shackle him to Roshan, and he's going to go down. No, the phase shift. The ALT only going to hit on one. No, it's actually going to hit on JJS. Now, Bardo going to go down in the backside. Pseudo Me is going to be able to get a kill over here on the Windrunner. It looks like Sexy Steve going to be the next one down, and he does have his ultimate here. There's the ult from Mr. J. Going to be able to find Tico here as well with his hookshot. Has a 4 staff with the cogs as well. We'll be able to spend it. That's going to be a 5-for-0 trade. Not even going to be able to kill Mr. J here. And the Dire going to look to close this one out very soon, I imagine. And I think earlier today or sometime this week, I casted somebody named Pseudo Me, so I keep saying Pseudo Me, but sorry, Pseudo. Don't mean to get your name wrong, but it does happen. And they will rotate to this bot lane. Flare top, gonna buy themselves a little bit more time with that creep wave as mid lane. Polvirizer, looks like he is going for the same thing, Sheepstick, that I had expected he would go for earlier on. And a lot of heroes respawning now. They do have the eggs, or excuse me, the Aegis over here on the Pseudo, and it's gonna be very squishy, or excuse me, very slippery now to kill this Slayer, because look at the damage they've got. A lot of agility stolen here. It looks like 24 agility being stolen, 8 points of essence shift, and a lot of people don't realize how much essence shift you can really get with 4 points into that passive. 120 second duration, just lasting so long. ALT? Flare to follow up on this Witch Doctor. Maybe, as it looks like it will go down, and it will hit him, so he's gonna be in base. No Aghanim Scepter yet on the AA, and if he did have it, I imagine that would be a kill, and it, 22 seconds, and now this Witch Doctor, he's gotta be so careful, even gonna buy a headdress. I think it's worth it to buy the casual cloak here, as we do have the smoke up. Looks like it will get revealed here. There's the blink up, and they will shackle onto Pseudo here, and they've got the A ultimate. They're going to throw everything in his Pseudo. The A ulti going to easily be able to hit all these heroes. There's the Dreamcall actually going to land on 4, as well as the Waning Rift going to continue to land. Slammi not going to be able to get his ultimate off. There's the cast bouncing around. No mana just yet. Pseudo is going to respawn, and now it looks like they're going to go onto the Puck, who's got full HP still. There's the charge, excuse me, the bash from JJS. He's going to get bashed up himself here. There's the ultimate now being channeled from Tico. Pseudo Me getting quite low now at about half HP. There's the Waning Rift. They're going to secure a double kill. Pseudo Me getting stunned up. Has a little bit before he can use his Shadow Blade. About 1 second. Will be able to do so. Getting rid of that shackle shot. It looks like Black Cat's still shackled though, and there's the ALT gonna land on 2. It looks like we'll be able to get the kill on the Sexy Steve, as well as Kyleep gonna go down here, and El Bardo gonna get caught out as well. Is gonna use the Aghanim Scepter as well as the Shallow Grave. Is gonna keep him alive a little bit longer here, and he will die. There's the ultra kill here for Polvirizer, and it's gonna be a 5-man wipe, and it should be the Rax as well as the GG. Look at the net worth lead, 20k almost on the dot. EXP telling an even worse story, 30k EXP lead, and the Dire looks like they should be able to easily close this one out. Mr. J is going to finish up the Yule Scepter of his own here. And Tico will respawn. Doesn't have a Force Staff to make a play here, though. Was trying to finish up the mechanism. And it looks like they will go for the double Rax. Wraith King will have his ultimate when he comes back up. But Pseudo, just so hard to contend with, as it will be actually the Lincoln Sphere on the Puck. And you know what? I do agree with that. Maybe a little bit more than the Sheep Stick. The Sheep really means that they can take one of these heroes out of the fight, but the Lincoln Sphere means they have no way to kill Polvirizer now. Absolutely no control for him, as Slammi is going to be able to find a kill over here in this mid lane. Or excuse me, in the fountain, they're going to be able to kill this Witch Doctor with the Flare, as well as the ultimate here, and that's going to be 2 lanes of Rax. They won't be able to get the third because the tower is still up. They are going to throw out the Power Shot and really just holding on to all they can, but with 2 lanes of Rax down and only a BKB on this Wraith King, there's really no hope of them coming back, I imagine. I know sometimes as a caster, you're supposed to be a little bit more positive than that, but realistically, seems like Kleep kind of feels the same as well. And they will rotate just to go for this top lane. It will be the completed butterfly now on the Slark. Boots of Travel recipe for Slammi as well, so does have a Boots of Travel. Does throw down the ultimate towards, I believe, the mid lane. It will land on Sexy Steve, who is going to have to rotate back into his fountain here. JJS going to eat that one as well, but not going to be that big of a deal for him, as Flare is going to go out. Not going to hit on anything just yet. They did look for the hook, I imagine, on Mr. J. Bot lane, JJS is going to get graved. Didn't really need it all that much, though. As the Slark will find out the Witch Doctor, and essentially we're just waiting for the GG at this point. So they will throw out an offensive weave. We'll catch out Mr. J as well as Pseudo. There's the hook in. They are going to catch Sexy Steve. The cogs back, I imagine. There it is. A nice cogs from him. There's the good game well played from JJS. They will be able to get the Waning Rift as well as the Dream Coil onto 2. El Bardo is going to get stunned up here as well. They should be able to kill this Wraith King twice. The A ultimate is going to land here as well onto Sexy Steve. And there it is. Ancient's going to explode. Good game well played to both teams. Some nice NA Dota RD2L action. Thanks again to everybody watching. My name is 5869casting. For those of you watching in Dota TV, you can find me youtube.com/c/5869casting, 5869 casting. Same with twitch.tv. When I do start casting on that as well, it will be twitch.tv/5869casting. And thanks again, everybody, for watching. Was a good game, 37 minutes, fairly short, so kept it sweet and short. And Thanks again for those of you guys playing, and for those of you guys watching, have a good one.
Hey everyone, thanks for checking out the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to check out some of my other videos. I have my series from Lane to Lane where I just cast some everyday pubs that you guys send me. I also do some more professional pubs like games from Koikva, Miracle, whoever I can get my hands on from Dota Buff. I have a learning series as well, so feel free to check that out. There's some more info in the description as well as some videos linked in the annotations at the end here. Thanks a lot.